Let me define at any time u a of t as so this is our upper confidence bound based on by Bernstein inequality, right? Bernstein or Hofding's inequality which we have obtained. So this ujt is simply going to be whatever this quantity we have. So 2 log t by tj t minus 1. See, when I computed this jt, it is just based on the empirical means. So jt is so we after but here I have not yet written, right, like how I am going to. So when I said set jt, right, how is this set jt set? It is just like you and after every in every time t you will have this I for all I. This is the estimates for each of my arms. That is just simply the empirical average that I am going to take. Based on that, I have taken the first top m arms. These are the remaining arms. Now this is what I have used to define my jt set and to resolve the conflict between the edge points. I have used my confidence terms, upper and lower confidence terms. Okay, this is not just this, sorry, it is actually the mean value plus the confidence term. And the lower confidence term is the mean value minus the same lower confidence. So this is the input to you. You can use whatever the confidence term you are going to use and then plug in here, then you are going to get this algorithm. Okay, but when I said this algorithm is KLLUCB, this algorithm KLLUCB is going to use a confidence terms which are based on KL divergence that came from other set of concentration inequality, that is large deviation principles. These confidence terms came from what? Like as we said, Hofding's inequality. But we said that how good the algorithm depends on how tight these confidence terms are. If the confidence terms are tight, maybe I can also get a better performing algorithm. So other possibility for, let me call this as UCB here. Other possibility for these terms are, they are called KL divergence. And what is the confidence term we used in our KL UCB algorithm? It looks something like this, right? Same thing. Oh, sorry. So remember, this is the confidence terms. This is the indexes. So this was what we called UCB indexes, right? Indices. We ranked in the UCB. We used only upper confidence band to rank the all the arms, and then played the one with the highest index. In the KLUCB, we use this as the index, and we rank the arms based on this value, and we play the arm with the highest index. Now we are just saying, when I am going to define this pure exploration algorithm, we are actually using both this upper and confidence, upper and lower confidence bounds, and we are going to either use this pair of upper and confidence bound, or we could use this one, which are coming from two different methods. Now the question is, which one is tighter? Is this one is tighter or this one is tighter? So did Pinsker said this? Pinsker just said
there was this small derivation which was
simple. Right. So okay, so suppose if these are the tighter ones, which confidence bounds you like to use? So naturally you want to use the second one, right? Because if they are going to have a tighter one. So it can be shown that what we are going to have is this LUCB. So what we are saying is, the upper confidence term we get from KLUCB is dominated by that we could have obtained from the UCB. That means this is a tighter one, right? And also on the lower confidence bound, we are saying that the lower confidence bound we get from the UCB method is, or maybe instead of UCB, I just call Hofding's. Maybe Hofding's. So this algorithm, so is the now algorithm complete. So now I am going to, in the KLUCB version of this, we are going to use this confidence terms. So just to replace this U and L functions are defined like this at every time. And using that, you are going to compute this UT and LT functions. Now once you are able to compute UT and LT function, you can compute this BT function, and then your algorithm completes. So as you might have noticed, when you are trying to implement compare your UCB against KLUCB, you observe this to be better than the UCB, but you are able to compute this efficiently, this indices. This indices computing, it is much easier, right? It is just like empirical estimates and then adding this term, whereas this itself is an optimization problem. You are, all of you are able to compute this fast?
It took time.
It took time? Okay. But you optimized the time, or you just let it run? Huh? You did manual search. So, I mean, did you notice how much time it reduced before you optimize and after optimize? If it was taking before 2 hours, after you optimize, how much time it took? Just take few seconds. But binary search, how did you set the precision? Like the precision was good enough, or yeah, epsilon, you set some 1 or 0.001, 10 to the power. Even for that, it was converging in few seconds. Okay, fine. So you will face the same difficulty here, but you need to resolve that. Okay, when you are going to implement this algorithm. Okay, fine. So this is the algorithm, it actually performs good. I am not going to right now give what is its bound, what is its sample complexity. We will discuss it in the next class. So just take this as an algorithm now. So we are going to look at another algorithm called LIL-UCB. So LIL stands for here law of so I'm just going to discuss this algorithm again and we'll not discuss much about its sample complexity. Okay, I just want to, but we have asked you to compare this algorithm with KLUCB algorithm. Then you see that both have its own issues. By the way, what are the inputs I needed for what are the tuning parameters in the KLUCB algorithms? What are the things you need to tune? Epsilon is the one thing you need to tune. Okay, there is also. So, okay, if I am going to use KLUCB, there is also this beta sequence, right? This is another thing I need to tune. So, how did you tune this beta in the KLUCB algorithm before? It was some log t. So it is log t plus log something, right? So, what did you do with the log term? You just made it 0, that is. So, you have to see like, that is one tuning parameter you have to set. Had you not set it to 0, but you set it to some other value. So there was, I think, if you are right, it was log t plus some 3 log t, right? There was a some constant multiplying log t. So you set that constant to be 0. But did you any of you try if instead of setting that constant to be 0, if I just set it 1, did it improve or worsen the situation? You did not run. So you should try this time. Okay. See that if you are just going to, so whoever you gets the best performance. So do mention what is the value you are going to get for C there. When you submit the report, just mention what is that value you are going to see. Okay. So we will see. So you have to set this parameter epsilon. When that is without, and you have to set this epsilon without knowing it, right? So this is one hurdle in this algorithm, like how to set this appropriately. This is a tuning parameter. And another thing is, okay, we know that setting that constant to be 0 works better, but it's not necessary that every time 0 setting constant is the better. Maybe in some cases setting it to be some positive value may work out better. And U and L, these are anyway, but the main tuning parameters are epsilon and this beta. So see that in your when you implement that, if you play with this parameter, see if you are going to get a better sample complexity, and report that. Like when I set this epsilon, it worked best for this problem setting. Okay. Okay. So keeping that in mind, let's see this algorithm. What all the things that this algorithm needs to be tuned. What kind of algorithm you like? The one with the minimum tuning parameters or with lot of tuning parameters? You want it to be the one with the minimum, right? Like that means your intervention in the algorithm is minimal. And these are all supposed to be learning or artificially intelligent algorithm. So your interference should be smaller, and they should be, if at all there are parameters, they should be automatically tuning themselves instead of you manually interfering. Okay, this algorithm, it's going to temp input as. So by the way, where is the input? Like I said, these are all for a given delta parameters, right? Where did the delta come into picture here? So the delta is absorbed in this beta functions, right? How was the delta influencing this beta functions? Okay, so just when you are going to implement, check that how this delta, where you are going to use this delta, and if I am going to change this delta, your simplicity is. So if you are going to increase your delta, what should happen? Increasing delta means what? You are able to tolerate more errors, right? That means it should, your algorithm should terminate fast. So play with that and see. I think in your question, you might have fixed that delta to be something. If you are fixed, fine. But if you want yourself check whether if I'm going to change delta, anything varies in the algorithm, you can just try out that as well. Confidence delta and parameters epsilon and lambda. I'm just going to take this. Now initialize. So the way I define this KLUCB algorithm, it is trying to identify the top m arms, but you can just set m to be equals to 1. In that case, it is trying to just identify the best arm, okay. So this algorithm I am writing it here, it is just trying to identify the best arm, okay, not the top m arms. It is just, its focus is to identify the just the best arm. So what this algorithm is doing is it initially samples everybody once, and then this is the stopping criteria for this algorithm. So the, like here the stopping criteria was whether the BT is going to be epsilon or not. So here it is going to check. So when this this condition is going to be violated, if there is, if for some ni happens to be larger than the sum total number of pools of all the others. Whenever that has happened, then this criteria is violated and then it is going to stop. Otherwise, it is going to continue. Okay? So when it continues, it is going to always play the arm, which is again this algorithm defines some UCB index that is coming from some new concentration bound that is called law of iterated logarithm. Not going to that, this is another concentration bounds like based on Hoffding's and whatever KL UCB. So this, they are going to define UCB index like that. And what, whenever they are going to play IT, they are going to update the count of that. For others, no count is updated. So here it should be NI. And then once it so happens that number of pulls of a particular arm happens to be larger than the sum of pulls of all the other arms, then this guy is going to stop. And then it is going to output the one which has been pulled maximum number of times at that point as the best arm. So it must be intuitively it makes stopping criteria makes sense. If it so happens that one guy has scored so much that it is larger than the sum of rest of the guys scored in the class, maybe that guy is best. So it is just going to use that algorithm. But when they do, somehow they are going to exploit this law of iterated algorithm and show that this algorithm stops with finite time and it has a good sample complexity. Especially I think their result, the sample complexity result holds for two arms, but you can check how good it is compared to the KL UCB algorithms. Okay, so now there are certain parameters again here to be tuned. What are the things to be tuned?
Sigma.
Yeah, two sigma square. So okay, another thing they are going to assume that my distributions are sigma sub Gaussian. That parameter is that sigma. Okay, but they are also assumed that even though it is sub Gaussian, but the means are all in the interval 0, 1. The support could be large, but the means are restricted to the interval 0, 1. Okay, so this is for a sub-Gaussian distribution with parameter sigma square. So everything is defined, right? Okay, let's see this. Let's focus on this lambda. Suppose if I increase lambda, do you think it's a sample, its stopping criteria is going to met early or late? It is going to met, right? Like I want the best guy to be much, much better than the rest all put together. But if I this lambda happens to be smaller, maybe it will come down. So then again this becomes a tuning parameter. I mean I can't like a priori decide what is the best lambda here, right? So you have to maybe just play with this also. Let's say when you are going to say this guy is going to be superior to this or the other way around, see that what are the parameters you need to tune and see that by tuning them, suppose let's say this guy beats this guy. Now this guy is a poor chap here, right? Let's try to give him some advantage. Try to tune any of his parameter and see that this guy overtakes this guy. Okay, so just like do this. I mean, it may not be. It may happen that one guy beats the other by too much amount. But if you see that they are very close, so that there is not much difference between this guy happens to be beat this guy. This sample complexity turned out to be just 50 here, and for this guy it turned out to be just 60. I tried to tune this parameter and see it can come down by 50. And just some simple manipulations. That is just for the experiment purposes. Okay, now the two algorithms I said, these are kind of already old algorithm. The one, the KL UCB, I said that came in 2013, and this LIL UCB, it came in 2014. Subsequently, people have developed many algorithms. Okay, so if any of you are interested to study this pure exploration, you can take this as a project topic. Earlier, this was not listed, or maybe like you were not aware of this topic, right? So because of that, if anybody has not taken but you want to look into this, you can still take it. Okay. I don't recall all the names, but I think there are quite a good few more algorithms that have come, which have also some better theoretical guarantees, and also I don't know the empirical. Empirical, there are debates. Some people say it's hard to beat. KLUCB says does most of the time, but I remember like somebody said there is one more algorithm that has come recently which does sometimes better than this. That is open for explorations. So if you one of you are much interested, you can do all the comparisons of these algorithms and maybe write a nice report of comparison and doing it a rigorous job of doing comparing it under different environment setting. So okay, so let's stop here.